Hello, my name is Melanie Moon. I'm a membership engagement manager with Girl Scouts of Nepean Pathways. We serve 24 counties in New York and 2 in Pennsylvania, providing opportunities to over 11,000 girls with the support of nearly 2,000 troop volunteers. Thank you so much for joining me today. I'm going to be sharing with you how to complete step 2 of the Junior Digital Leadership Badge. We will be discovering your digital footprint. For this activity, you're going to need about 25 to 35 minutes to complete. The materials needed are your My Digital Data Tracker, which is one of your meeting aids, some paper, some either pencils or markers, whatever your preference is. You can also personalize with additional resources like construction paper, string, tape, things like that. First, we're going to start talking about technology. Technology can help us solve problems. We use devices like computers, smartphones, and tablets to help us learn. We use them to also have fun. We use them to connect with other people. Data is information that you create or information that is stored by a computer. Every time you click while using a device, you create data. You create data when you do your homework on a computer, and you create data when you connect with your friends on your phone too. And just like people's feet can make tracks as they walk in the mud or the snow, many things you do with technology can create a digital footprint. It's the record of your digital activity. Now, data isn't visible by everyone, but some of it can be visible to those who know how to look for it. That's why it's important to think about what data you share. So for example, businesses can use data to sell products to people. We're going to start by exploring your own digital footprint. Can you find ways to make technology even better or more useful? So let's start by filling out that My Digital Data Tracker to examine how you are using technology. Once that's all done, look at your data. Which devices or apps do you use the most? Now, which do you use the least? What problems do the devices or app help you solve? Are you following digital safety rules when you're online? So let's talk about some of those basic safety rules. You're always going to ask an adult for help, get permission, or make sure an adult is nearby when you're going online. Reach out if you're upset or angry and you think a friend needs help, and always ask an adult if someone you don't know is trying to contact you. Be thoughtful about what you're sharing online. Only talk to people you know and trust online. And only share public information. Things like your opinion about the movie you just saw or what you had for dinner. Don't talk to strangers or share private information like your phone number, an email, any passwords, things like that. Think before you click and share. So the things that you're going to be posting online, make sure you're getting permission from others if it's video or photos of someone else. Don't open or click on links or attachments from other people if you don't know them. Generally, just don't share anything that could make others feel bad, like gossip or bad words, and really anything that's unkind. You want to build a supportive digital community, and you deserve to be safe and have a positive online experience, and so do your friends. If someone bullies you or someone you know online, tell them to stop and tell a trusted adult. The last thing is you want to balance your time. Pay attention to how much time you're spending in the digital world. How do you feel before and after you're emailing, texting, or looking at videos? Spend time every day connecting in the real world. Talk with friends and family, get outside, do a craft or a hobby, something you enjoy. So now we're going to create technology for a favorite character. So choose a character from a movie, TV show, a book, a video game. What do you know about that character? How would you describe that character to others? Make a list of the information that you know about your favorite character. Write everything down. This is your character's data set. Now you're going to choose a problem or an obstacle that your character encounters in the story. How could technology help? Use the data set to brainstorm ideas like an app, a device, or some other kind of technology. Then sketch out or make a model of your idea. This is where you can use that paper, cardboard, tape, string, or any other material, depending on what your idea is and how you want to represent it. Now, finally, when you're all done with that creation, we want you to share it. Share it with another Girl Scout or someone who's familiar with that character. Make sure you explain how you'll use the data set to create the problem-solving technology. I really hope that you enjoyed this portion of your Junior Digital Leadership Badge. You can explore remaining steps of this badge, as well as other fun activities on Girl Scouts at Home. You can visit your Girl Scout shop at girlscouts.org for more information and more ideas, or you can reach out to your local Girl Scout Council or your troop leader. Thank you so much for joining me.